What's going on YouTube? Welcome back to another video, and today I'm going to be showing you how to make this Kieran Turney poster that I made a few weeks ago. It's pretty similar to the Zaha poster, but it's a nice technique and I thought you guys would like to make it with me. So there's going to be the texture link in the description down below, and yeah, that's about it guys. Let's get straight into the video. So the first thing we need to do is make the background. So the background is going to be 1080 by 1350, standard for Instagram, so it'll fit perfectly. So we're going to click OK. We don't really need a big canvas for this design because it's not very, it's not that big, so it should be all right. We're going to go to the textures first, and we're just going to turn that off and turn textures on. Now, I've got three sets of textures here. They're in the order that they will need to be laid out in. So I've got paper 04, which is 72% opacity. Then I've got the normal texture, which is just normal. And then I've got texture number 9, which is difference and 20%. So this is sort of a half tone pattern. We can increase this a little bit if you want, but in the camera filter later, it will come through more. So I'm just going to drag and drop these in the design and just need to position the paper directly in the center. Make it a little bit bigger if you want, just so it completely fits like that. Now, if I turn this one up, as you can see, it's quite harsh texture. So I'm just going to keep it down about 30% maybe, just so it's a little bit more distinctive in the design. And then we're going to just group these together and call them textures or background. So BG for background. So we've got the background done. We don't need to worry about that too much now. We can lock that in place. So what we're going to do now is we are going to drop some images in. Now, I've already cut the images out just to save time, but you can go find your own images if you want and try this out with different players. But yeah, I've got them here. So I've got this Turney big copy here. So I'm going to drop this one in the center of the design. So we're going to position him probably around here. He is good. And what we're going to do with him, we are going to give him a camera raw filter to make him black and white. So let's go to filter, camera raw filter, and this should load up. And what we're going to do is go to basic and go to saturation and just decrease it basically. Then what we want to do is increase the clarity and texture and contrast, and that should do really. So once we do the overall camera raw filter for the whole design, it will look a lot more better. But this is what we need to do for now, just so we can get a sense of the design and see what it's going to look like. So what we're going to do now is we're going to get the second image again, drop it in, and we're just going to probably position him around there, somewhere like that. That looks good. Obviously, you can move him around wherever you want them in the design. It's not too important, but yeah. Obviously, if you're using different images, we've done this technique of cutting out the grass in the previous video in the Zaha tutorial, which will be in the description below. So check that one out and then come back to this one. This one's just going to be more of a quick placement sort of design. So we've got this one here. What I'm going to do now is I'm going to do a camera filter on this one as well. So same again, saturation decreased, clarity upped, and texture upped, and the contrast upped. And then we're just gonna click OK, and that's perfect, that's all done. So what we're gonna need to do now is we're gonna need to add some typography. So let's just go and get our type tool. Now we got an Anton font, so gonna be similar to the previous design. So we're gonna write Tierney, so like that. And we can just position it here. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to position it on its side and I'm going to increase size until it meets the edge of that image. So like that. And then we're going to drop it below like that. Then we're just going to reduce the fill to 0% and then go to blending options and add a stroke. Now I want the stroke to be about 2. Change the color to black. There we go. As you can see, that looks really good, doesn't it? So what we're going to do now is we're going to duplicate this. Command T. And we're going to move this one down here and flip it on its head, and we can put this one down here. You can make it smaller if you want, but I'm going to leave it that size. So I'm just going to write Kieran for his second name. There we go. And if I just drop this down a little bit like so. Now I am going to make the stroke a little down to 1 just because I think it looks better. So again, I'm going to do that with both of them. Just change the stroke to 1 so it's a bit more subtle effect. And I am going to decrease the size of them a little bit just so they're not too big, but you can still read them. That looks good. So now we're going to need to do a little texture down here. Not a texture, a match day down the side. Or we can type Arsenal, we can type match day, we can type game day. Anything you want. Maybe we should put Arsenal just because it's an Arsenal player, obviously. So let's do a really thin black line down there with your rectangle tool. Maybe even make it a little bit thinner than that. So something like that. That's good. And we can move him in a little bit. There we go. Now we're just going to zoom in. And we're going to get our type tool again. Change the color to white. Go like that. And then we're just going to type Arsenal. Let me just check. I don't think I spelled that right. Nope. Make sure you spell it right, otherwise it will look a bit stupid.
Got it! Got it!
And then we're just going to reduce the size of this really small, rotate it on its side, and then put it in this little black rectangle, like so. Then we're going to duplicate this and move it down. And do the same again, duplicate them, move them down, and then we can duplicate them and move them down. So it's going to be a similar process, just going to be moving these down, and yeah, just basically like that. And then at the end, we will position them all so they're equally spaced out between each other with the usual tool. Once you've done this, you will need to position them. So let me just move this one down here, like that. There we go. Now we can group them or select them all. Select all the copies of text, and then you go up here where it's this little gap with two lines above it and below it, and you just click that and it positions them all so they're equally spaced out. And then what you're gonna do is group them together and type arsenal down the side. There we go. So we can drop the rectangle in there as well and just make sure the rectangle's at the bottom of the pack. So like that, there we go. And now we can just select everything in here again, and we're just gonna position them down the middle and flat to the design. There we go. Oh, no, we don't want that. Okay, so just press the middle arrow so they're nice and centered in there. So that looks good. So we got that done. Now we're going to have a signature up on the left here. We're going to have a Adidas logo on the right, and then we're going to have an image down here. So we'll drop the image in first. All right, guys, I'm interrupting the video just now to tell you that there's only 20 or 30% of you subscribe to my channel that are watching these videos. So I just want to let you know, if you are watching the video, subscribe. It would mean a lot if we had the 70% of you who aren't subscribed. I'll put it on the screen now. If I had all those people subscribed, we'd have way more subscribers and way more people would be getting like some productivity out of these videos. They'd hear about them more and it would just get pushed through the algorithm more. So if you have got a minute, guys, just a little bit of time, just to smash that subscribe button on this video, that would be great. I'm doing all I can to make these videos great for you, and I'm learning new techniques, so hopefully it will be better for you in the future. But I will make it worth your while, so if you smash that subscribe button and hit the like, I'd really appreciate it. So thank you. I hope you're enjoying the video, and let's get back to it. So it's going to be this Arsenal Stadium here, so just drop this in. I'm going to position it on the side here. You can make it smaller if you want, if you don't want it so close to the ball. So somewhere around there looks good. And then we're going to go get a sticker, which I made for the logo in the logos part of the design. So it's going to be this little Scotland logo here. So we can drag and drop this one in. So it's going to be placed right there on the corner. So it's sort of joining the images together and sort of making the design feel a bit more complete. So we've got that done. I'm just going to turn the images off so I know what I've got down here. Autograph going to be up in the top right corner. Now I am going to be doing a video in the future showing how to get people's autographs, like how to copy them and trace them into designs, because I think it's a nice little touch that it adds to the design. It really does make it look good. So we're going to do that in a future video when I've got a bit more time, because that takes a while. And I am in the process of the moment of getting the live streams up and running. So once I get the live streams up and running, we can do longer videos, like just not day sessions, but like a couple of hours of just designing a poster, and you can really see how I like do each little bit. So if you are looking forward to that, hit the like button, obviously. And yeah, that should be fun in the future. I'm looking forward to it. So let's just position this one down here. Yeah, so as you can see, guys, I've just been talking away, but I've added in the Adidas logo and the Canon down the bottom. And yeah, it sort of looks pretty similar to what we had in the original. So I'll just put them side by side at the moment, just so you can see what they look like. And as you can see, they are very close to each other. One more thing we need to do now is add a camera or filter. We can obviously group these logos together just to make it easier for us to navigate. And we can just type this one in images. Like that. Nice. Okay, so heading. I've learned that grouping your layers together, it does make it a lot easier when trying to look back through a design. So if you need any consistency in your designs, this is the best way to go about it, because it's clean. You can find every little asset that you need in the design. It really does help a lot. So I really do advise doing this. So what I'm going to do now, I am going to unlock everything, and I'm going to make a screenshot so we can do our camera filter. So Command Shift Option E, screenshot, that's good. And then we're going to go to filter, camera or filter, and we're just going to sort of make everything look a bit sharper and a bit, just a bit better really. So we can put the exposure up a tiny bit, contrast up a little bit. Highlights, shadows, obviously you can play around them yourself. Texture I'm going to increase, and clarity I'm definitely going to increase. So this is looking a lot like what we had before. Dehaze you can play around with. I don't really bother with it too much. So curve, not going to be a lot of shadows in this design, obviously, because, yeah. And sharpening we're going to increase a lot. So it just brings out all those nice little details. See that the background's come through a lot more now, because obviously it's quite harsh anyway. So once you increase it with this, it obviously increases. So we've got that done. Next one we're going to do is add a grain. So 30 grain. And then we're going to go vignette and bring the corners in like so, because it also intensifies the texture. So that looks really good, guys. As I can see, if I just do a side by side of what we've just done, obviously it looks way more intense and way more interesting. So that's good. And yeah, that's about it, guys. So I hope you enjoyed this video. Obviously there's not too many techniques learned here. It's more about placing things and sort of positioning them in ways that look good. So if you have enjoyed the video, leave a like, comment and subscribe. And thank you for hitting over 1,000 subscribers. We're well over the mark now, so that's just great. I appreciate all of you watching the videos and commenting and, you know, asking for more videos. It really does motivate me to do more. I will be finishing uni in a month, and I've got a lot of work to do over this next month, so the videos might be a bit not as long and not as detailed as you would like, but I'm trying to get them out for you. But once I finish uni over the summer, we'll be just banging out the videos and there'll be loads for you to watch. So hopefully you guys are looking forward to that. I know I am, so thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.